This new century, we live in a world that's grown smaller and more interconnected than at any time in history. Threats must be strong and vigilant in the face of these threats. But let us not allow whatever differences we have with other nations. Women are still more likely to live in poverty in this country. And Malia and Sasha may live in the White House these days, but Michelle and I still make sure they finish their homework, do their chores, and walk the dog. And they wanted to terrorize us, but as Americans, we refuse to live in fear. Yeah, but we live in the real world. We don't have unlimited resources. But we live in the real world, with real choices and real consequences. Enormous impact on the country we live in and the one we pass on to our children. Right now, we're still fighting our way back from the worst economic crisis. As Americans, we refuse to live in fear. Supporting the Red Cross is the best and fastest way. This week, we've been humbled by nature's destructive power.
We live in Sandy Hook, Connecticut.
To remember, with gratitude, the countless men and women who gave their lives so we could know peace and live in freedom. Today, we're blessed to live in a world where technology allows us to connect instantly with just about anyone on the planet. And that's why I call on members of Congress from both parties to come together and stand up for the kind of world we want to live in, the kind of world we want to leave our children and future generations. But if we want to live in a country where we can go to work, send our kids to school, and walk our streets free from fear, we have to keep trying. Because here in America, no one who works hard should have to live in poverty, and everyone who works hard should have a chance to get ahead. A clear majority of Americans support raising the minimum wage, because we believe that nobody who works full-time should have to live in poverty.
There's no reason in the world why an American working 40 hours a week has to live in poverty.
And while not all of us always see eye to eye politically, one thing we overwhelmingly agree on is that nobody who works full-time should ever have to live in poverty. And let's work together to end the tragedy of homelessness among veterans once and for all. Because anyone who has defended America deserves to live in dignity in America. In today's world, we have to equip all our kids with an education that prepares them for success, regardless of what they look like or how much their parents make or the zip code that they live in. Many of them live in the Asia Pacific, the world's fastest growing region. But we also live in a world where our workers have to compete on a global scale. Whether we are Democrats, Republicans, or independents, whether we live in one of our poorest communities, one of our wealthiest, or anywhere in between, we all want our country to be one where hard work pays off and responsibility is rewarded. This weekend is Memorial Day, a time to pay tribute to all our men and women in uniform who've ever given their lives so that we can live in freedom and security. Because we do live in a new economy. By the way, if you live in one of the 20 cities participating in our Healthy Communities Challenge, I want to see how many of your neighbors you can get to sign up. Of course, every American can be thankful for the chance to live in a country founded on the belief that all of us are created equal. As I said in my State of the Union address, we live in a time of extraordinary change, change that's affecting the way we live and the way we work.
Doesn't care what color you are, whether you're a guy or a girl, rich or poor, whether you live in an inner city, a suburb, or rural America. This doesn't just...
If you live in or travel to an area where Zika has been found, protect yourself against the mosquitoes that carry this disease. And to live in our own lives the values for which they were prepared to give theirs.